What's up, everybody, and welcome back to Arrival Entertainment. And today we are going to be talking about the newest film from writer and director M. Night Shyamalan, Old. Old is written and directed by M. Night Shyamalan, and it tells the story of a group of people that explore this mysterious beach located at their vacation resort that they're staying at. And they quickly find out that the longer they stay there, the older they become. For some mysterious reason, this beach makes you age rapidly, and our main characters have to find out how to get off of this beach, because every time they attempt to get off the beach, they get thrown right back onto the beach. Oh, M. Night Shyamalan, what a career this man has had. He has made some of the most unique movies of all time, and also some of the worst movies of all time. I consider his first few films, honestly, classics. My personal favorite film of his being Unbreakable. I think that is a very good and very unique movie. I also like Signs. The Sixth Sense is, of course, a classic. But then after The Village, his career took a turn very rapidly. The Happening, The Last Airbender, Lady in the Water, After Earth, all got negative reviews, poor box office, and it really damaged M. Night Shyamalan's career for a while. And I kind of felt bad for him, because while those movies, they're pretty bad, I do respect M. Night Shyamalan for taking risks with his movies, even though those risks and weird ideas didn't always work. Then came the film The Visit, and while I still haven't seen The Visit, that movie did get some pretty decent critic reviews and did okay for the most part, and it kind of boosted his career a little bit. But the movie that put M. Night Shyamalan back on in the public eye was the movie Split. I still have my original review for the movie Split, so if you want to know more about my opinions on the movie, then feel free to check out my review for it. But very briefly, that movie was a big surprise. It's very good, it still holds up, and it really did put M. Night Shyamalan back in the public eye at a good point for once. Then he followed that up with Glass, and Glass was a very divisive movie. I enjoyed the movie overall, although it did have some problems, but it did feel like he stumbled a little bit with Glass, though it was an enjoyable movie, although some fans didn't care for it, understandably so. So I was very curious going into Old. Was this going to be another stumble for M. Night Shyamalan, or was this another hit for him? And I did see some critic reviews before I went and saw the movie, and it wasn't doing too good. I did look up some reviews, and some reviews were, of course, trashing the movie, saying it's another bad M. Night Shyamalan movie, it's got all the things that made his bad movies bad in the movie, and that kind of dampened my expectations a little bit. I still went into the film with an open mind, but I kept my expectations in check, like I usually do. And leaving the movie, I'm on the opposite end of the spectrum. I'm not gonna lie, I really enjoyed this movie. Is it a great movie? No. Is it one of Shyamalan's best? Not best, but it's definitely one of his better movies. I actually thought this movie worked overall. Going into this movie, I knew this was going to be a weird premise, and this movie, the biggest word I can give this movie is weird. This is a weird movie with a weird idea, but that's M. Night Shyamalan. You know, he always takes risks with his stories. He always plays around with different ideas, and sometimes they work, sometimes they didn't, and I thought this one worked out. And I'm not the only one that was intrigued by this idea. I mean, my theater was kind of full, which was very refreshing to see after the ongoing pandemic and the whole thing, our movie theater's gonna be okay, yada yada. And the box office numbers for this movie, I heard, were pretty good. So obviously people are interested in this movie, which is a big plus, I could say. At the same time, I'm also someone that really likes and is intrigued by weird ideas for movies. For instance, The Lighthouse. I thought the trailers for that movie looked very strange, and it drew me to the movie, and I ended up loving that movie. So I gave this movie a chance because of the weird premise, and like I said, I thought it worked overall. I get that there's some problems with the movie, and let's talk about some of those problems really quick. One of the things that I've heard mentioned about this movie before going into it was some of the line delivery. And yeah, some of the line delivery was very wonky, kind of flat, and just weird. I don't know, it's hard to explain. Sometimes characters would often say things in the movie that just make you say, wait, what did he say? And how did he say it? But then other times characters would say something that would be kind of flat, and you would basically said, at least I said to myself, you're in a pretty serious situation. Shouldn't you show more emotion? And I think that is one of the weaker aspects of the movie. There are some line deliveries that I think could have used a couple more takes. I mean, this is a contained thriller. All these characters are in one location. And so the movie kind of relies on their performances. Now, in my opinion, there's a difference between an overall performance and line delivery. For me, when I look at a character performance, I don't just look at the line delivery, I look at their body language, their facial expressions, how they overall carry themselves when they act in a scene. And while their overall performances I thought were good, it's just the line delivery that lacked a little bit. Because when something intense would happen, it was pretty believable for the most part. There are a lot of scenes of characters talking to each other and explaining what's going on, and I can understand why M. Night Shyamalan chose to do that. Again, this is a weird idea, so you kinda need some explanation. Holding the audience's hand a little bit is fine. However, in this one, there was a little bit too much. It's like, you would kind of see something happening, and I said to myself, oh, okay, that's what's happening, and then a character would just straight up say it, and I'm like, okay, I didn't need to hear it. I could piece it together. Now, just like always, no spoilers for me. I'm not going to give anything away, but there is a twist ending. If you know M. Night Shyamalan's films, you know he always does twist endings. It's not a spoiler. I mean, when I saw the trailers, I knew for a fact right away that there was going to be a twist ending. Now, I'm not going to give away the twist ending, but I do think it was pretty cool, and I think it worked. Throughout this movie, if you decide to go see it, you're going to start to be confused. You're going to be like, okay, I don't get what's going on. This is strange. I'm not really getting a whole lot of answers. It's a lot of figuring things out, and you're going to be left a little unfulfilled as the movie goes along. But again, there is a twist ending. This movie kind of trusts you to stick with it as the film goes along, because you are going to get the answers. You just have to, it's just a slow burn to get to those answers, which I liked and appreciated, and I'll explain why in a little bit. But then as the ending goes along and you start to get those answers, it's like, boom, everything makes sense. You think back on the movie and you're like, okay, so that's why that happened, that's why this happened, and it all made sense. And that's why I think it worked, because slow burn stories like this that go, they give you the answers towards the ending in a twist ending, I appreciate. In my lifetime, I've seen quite a bit of movies that just give you the answers right away without any mystery, without any suspense, without any figuring out for yourself. And after a while, that starts to get really annoying and kind of boring to me, which is another reason why I was looking forward to this movie, because I know M. Night Shyamalan movies. I've seen quite a bit of them, and a lot of his movies, most of his movies, are slow burns until you get to that twist ending, and then puzzle pieces start to get together, you start to figure things out in your mind, and then you decide then if it worked or if it didn't work. And I really like and appreciate that M. Night Shyamalan is still making movies like that. Slow burn, but then you get all the answers at the end and a twist ending. You could say nowadays twist endings are just cliche, yada yada, they've been done a million times, and they have been done a million times. But when they work, they work. In an age of movies where we get a lot of big blockbuster movies like the MCU movies, Star Wars movies, DC Extended Universe movies, Transformers movies, movies that already have established franchises that get a nice juicy budget, it's nice to see a movie that's low budget, contained, takes a weird idea, and just goes for it. It was refreshing seeing this movie, and that could be why I liked it a little more than your typical movie viewer. I don't know. The only thing I know for a fact is that, yeah, this movie has problems. It definitely has some not-so-good parts, some pretty bad parts in it, but overall, I really enjoyed this movie, and I do think it's worth checking out. Again, is it one of his best movies? No, but it's definitely one of his better movies, if that makes sense. If you've seen the trailers for this movie and you're like, I'm not sure, that kind of looks weird, or you took a look at the critical reviews and you saw it was very mixed and you're like, I don't know if I want to invest my time in it, I think it's worth checking out. Just stick with it. You're going to get lost, you're going to get confused, you're going to want answers now, but if you stick with it, you're going to get those answers, and you'll feel, at least I did, more fulfilled by the time the movie was over. And the movie stuck with me. It really did. Again, I don't know why I view this movie differently than everyone else who's seen this movie, all the other YouTube critics, because a lot of people on YouTube aren't liking this movie, but I don't care anymore. I enjoyed this movie. I think it's worth checking out. And I think it's worth picking up on Blu-ray. I think this is a Blu-ray purchase. I do want to see the film again. pick up little things here and there. I don't know how much rewatchability this movie is going to have, but I do want to see the film again. And like I said, I think it's definitely worth checking out at least once. So guys, that's my review for Old. Just like always, let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comments section. What's your favorite M. Night Shyamalan movie? Where does Old rank in your M. Night Shyamalan ranking? Whatever your thoughts on everything is, let me know down in the comments section. And just like always, thank you again so much for watching. Look forward to a review for Snake Eyes. I plan on seeing that soon. And maybe Jungle Cruise. I haven't decided if I want to see Jungle Cruise, but nevertheless, thank you again as always for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to like and share it. Subscribe right here if you haven't already. And until next time, guys, take care.